On the navigation bridge, Commodore G.T. Marr is busy guiding the ship safely out to sea. As the skyline of Manhattan grows smaller and the Statue of Liberty is passed for the last time, there is one final salute from the tugs escorting the Queen before they turn back. Listen carefully for the Commodore's orders to the engine room as the ship heads into the open seas. While the Queen Elizabeth was designed for a service speed of 28.5 knots, she is capable of topping speeds of 30 knots. Located on the sun deck, just below the navigation bridge, is another nerve center of the ship, the wireless operations. From this room's complex array of radio equipment flows hundreds of messages. At any moment of the day or night, anyone aboard the great liner can pick up a telephone and be in contact with the farthest corners of the world. In the late fall, the North Atlantic can produce some rough weather conditions. 3 days out of New York on the final voyage, heavy seas with gale-force winds were encountered. What you are now hearing was recorded during the height of the storm as the gale-force winds whipped with all their fury through the rigging of the upper superstructure of the ship. Below D-deck, we hear the ship plowing through huge waves that sent tons of water and spray over the front decks. Burning fuel oil at a rate of 1,000 tons a day, 12 large water tube boilers supply steam to the main engines of the ship at a pressure of 425 pounds per square inch and a temperature of 750 degrees Fahrenheit. Four sets of single reduction geared turbines with 257,000 blades transfer the 425 pounds of steam pressure into circular motion to turn the four propellers. Two outboard sets are driven by the forward engine room, and the two inboard sets are driven by the after engine rooms. The turbines develop 160,000 horsepower. At this point, you are standing 15 feet below the waterline in what is known as the shaft galley. Here, four steel shafts, 28 inches in diameter, connect the turbine engines with the propellers outside the ship. Rhythmic splashing sounds above the drone of the shafts are the outboard propellers, which are directly outside the hull. Each propeller weighs 32 tons and is 18 feet in diameter. Of the morning of November 5th, as the Queen Elizabeth nudged gently against the pier at Southampton, hundreds of passengers lined the decks to sing goodbye to an old friend. Today, the Queen Elizabeth is enjoying a well-earned retirement at her permanent anchorage at Port Everglades, Florida, as a major tourist attraction, floating hotel, and convention center. But those who have ever traveled on the Queen Elizabeth have their own particular fond memories of this great ship.